guys, in this video we are going to talk about the copy number of plasmid control utilizing the different techniques or random partitioning technique. Now there are two types of plasmids there. One is multiple copy plasmids, another one is a small copy number plasmids. Now in case of those plasmids which are having a higher copy number, they can make this partitioning in a random way to ensure that they are getting all the plasmids on. Now there are two types of strategies actually. Let me take a color first. There are two types of strategies from one place. There are two different types of strategies. One strategy is there that you must produce a huge number of plasmids inside your cell, and that ensures that after the cell division, each cell get enough number of plasmids. And the second technology or the second technique that they can adapt is that they are not getting any huge number of plasmids. They are getting only a few, suppose one. So in that case, they need to ensure that one plasmid is totally replicated before the transfer to the daughter cell. Okay, so these are the two techniques. Now the first techniques we've talked about is in case of the higher copy number plasmids, and the second technique is in case of the small copy number plasmids. Now those plasmids which are having the higher copy number scheme, they are producing a lot of plasmid inside the cell. Now that ensures that whatever position from wherever the cell divides, from where whatever place the cell divides, it must contains enough number of plasmids to carry on their physiological success. Okay. On the other hand, if it only contains one plasmid or two plasmids, in those cases it has to maintain some very tight duration, and in those cases they need to ensure that the only one plasmid is replicated before transfer to the daughter cell.